Your in-laws, go to them and tell them. He told them, but they didn't accept. They didn't believe. That same visitation gave them the peril for the unbelieving. Peril for the unbelieving. I'm talking to believers tonight. Lord, I believe. Anybody there, Lord, I believe. Anybody there, Lord, I believe. That peril will pass over you in Jesus' name. Now the visitation affected Lot's wife. For Lot's wife, that visitation eventually resulted into the perdition of the ungodly. Perdition for the ungodly. The angels brought them out of Sodom and said, escape for your life. Look not behind thee. And then I said, we're going. Lot's wife, what are you thinking about? Look at angels, look at what they said. Look at destruction coming upon Sodom. And look at the favor of God upon you and your family. And look at the mountains you flee to. But the Bible says that she looked back and she became the pillar of salt, the perdition of the ungodly. I pray you'll come out of that ungodliness tonight. And the visitation of God will mean a great way of escape for you tonight in Jesus' name. Now Sodom and Gomorrah, all those Sodomites, all those abominable people, all those sinners, they had a chance. They could have been saved. Abraham prayed for them. They could have been saved. Angels came over there. They could have been saved. They saw the miracle of being blindfolded. And that time they were blindfolded. They knew that power came from heaven. They knew that these were messengers from heaven. These were the angels of God. Angels visited our city. Angels performed a miracle in our city. Angels did what we have never seen in Sodom. He sent blindness to everyone. And then after that, he sent Lot out. And Lot was knocking on doors. And angels protected Lot. They couldn't touch him. And after that, angels brought them out. They had eyes to see. They had ears to hear. They had minds to think. But they remained unrepentant. On a day like this, when God is visiting Ajegunle, and when God is visiting all those other places who are hearing me now, you will repent. I said you will repent. I said you will repent. A miracle will come your way. Somebody that is getting a miracle. I said somebody that is getting a miracle. The people of Sodom, they urge the punishment for the unrepentant. The punishment for the unrepentant. See, I've shown you now. Different things happen to different people. Depending on your attitude to the visitation of God. God's day of visitation. God's day of visitation. You will respond properly. You will react positively. And something good will come your way. I said something good will come your way. I'm looking at three things here. Number one, the sins of residents in Sodom. The sins of residents in Sodom. And don't let that surprise you. Here we are. Look at the places we live. Here we are. Look at your neighbors. Here we are. Look at community people. Here we are. Look at what happens in the night. Here we are. Look at the nightclubs. Here we are. Look at everything happening in our city here. The seas of residence is Sodom. I'm looking at Genesis chapter 18. And I'm reading here from verse 20. The Lord said, because the cry of Sodom and Gomorrah is great, and because their sin is very grievous. He wanted to see repentance. He will see repentance today here. He wanted to see a turning around. Because God said, you have been doing it and doing it and doing it. Now I come. I can come with mercy. I can come with judgment. I can come with miracle. I can come with chastisement. I can come with law. I can come with justice. They should have begged the Lord. They should have repented of their sins. Look at Genesis chapter 13, verse 13. Genesis 13, verse 13. He's talking about the people of Sodom, the residents of Sodom, the inhabitants of Sodom. And he says in verse 13, but the men of Sodom were wicked and sinners before the Lord exceedingly. The sins of the people of Sodom. What do you know about Sodom? Well, Sodom and Sodomites. Sodom are the people that were defiling themselves with mankind. Sodom and lesbianism. Sodom and man marrying man. Sodom and woman marrying a woman. Sodom and fleshly action. And God said, I'm going to visit them. They should have realized the holy God of heaven is visiting us. Where that you were defiled. They should have repented immediately. Like Nineveh repented. And God said, I will not destroy them anymore. Like Nineveh repented. And God said, I will not judge them, I will give mercy. Tonight is a night you can have the mercy of God. I said you can have the mercy of God. Because if God will deal with you like he dealt with the Sodomites, where will you be? Because God is a righteous God. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. And because he's holy, he's of purer eyes than to behold iniquity. The sins of the residents of Sodom. Sodomites were wicked people. You can tell when those angels came. And then they came to the house. They wanted to throw down the door. Bang the door, destroy the door. They wanted to rape those angels, those men. And they said, where are the men? We will know them. Their tools were sharp. They are violent people, destructive people, wicked people. They were ready for a fight. And then Lord said, don't do like that. They said, get out of the way. We will even deal with you more seriously, more violently than even with them. They said, this fellow came over here to sojourn and now he wants to control us. They were wicked people. Don't you know people like that? How about yourself? Are you a violent person? That's Sodom. Are you a wicked person? That's Sodom. Are you ready for a fight? You fight with the whip. You fight with machete. You fight with cutlass. You fight with God. You fight with anything. You fight with broken bottle. The Sodom. And the Lord is coming to you today. He's saying that you may sin for 100 days. You may sin for 1,000 days. One final day is coming when God will come to visit. And when he comes to visit, you better bow the knee before the Almighty God. You better bow the head before the Almighty God. You better turn away from your violence before the Almighty God. Because if the residents of Sodom do not repent, judgment will come upon them. I see somebody there, you're a reasonable person. You're not going to wait for the judgment of God. You say, Lord, mercy is what I need. Somebody there, mercy is what I need. Somebody there, forgiveness is what I need. Somebody there, love is what I need. You know, if you have the right attitude, when God visits your land, when God visits our community, say, Lord, I am sorry. I will not remain in violence. I will not remain in fighting. Then the Lord will forgive you. Somebody is getting forgiveness tonight. What is he there? What is she there? The mercy of God will flow to your side. Salvation will come to you. The peace of God will come to you. The sins of the residents in Sodom. Oh, the Bible says about these people. It said they were proud. The Bible says about these people. It said they had idleness. It said about these people, abundance of bread. Look at that one by one. The people of Sodom, they were proud. They were poor and proud. They were tattered and proud. They were ignorant and proud. They were sinful and proud. They were backward and proud. Look at Sodom. Because of idleness, there was no development. Look at Sodom. Because of idleness, normally in the cities of those days, they normally build a wall around them. Look at Sodom. There was no protecting wall. There was no security. They were insecure and proud. Look at our people. Look at yourself. Poor and proud. Ignorant and proud. In tatters and proud. Jobless and proud. Sinful and proud. And God is coming today. God says, what are you proud about? I want to bless you, and then you are drawing back. What are you proud about? If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, the Lord says he'll have mercy upon you tonight. Mercy is coming upon you tonight. Forgiveness is coming upon you tonight. I said forgiveness is coming for you tonight. Those people, they were idle people. Look at young people. And during the school hours, I thought you would have gone to school. They don't go to school. Idle. Look at the people that took to be in the farm working. And during the day, you see able-bodied men. They're just roaming up and down. I thought you'd be at work. They are not at work, idle. Look at women, able-bodied women. I thought you'll be at the market. No, they'll be roaming about. They will stay by the street corner. They're looking for cheap money. They're looking for idle men that will meet idle women. And then they carry them about to get cheap money. But today is the day of visitation. And God is saying, I can have mercy upon you today. I can forgive you today. I can cleanse you today. I will change your life today. But if you don't want a change, I will bring judgment. The day of judgment came for them because they will not repent. Thank God you are repenting today. Thank God your life will be different today. And then in Sodom, it says abundance of bread. Eating, and eating. They were living to eat. They were not eating to live. They were eating. They were living to eat. That is, they committed themselves to eating. Committed themselves to drinking. They eat this. Everything they eat. Everything is for the mouth. Eating, eating, and eating. Only living to eat. But you know what the Lord wants us to do? He wants us to eat so we can live and work. Eat so we can be strong and help other people. Eat so that we can live a reasonable life. Eat to live. But they turned it around. They were living to eat. And God said, I want a change. I want a turning around. But those people, there was no change. But thank God there are changing. There are people who are going to change tonight. I said there are people who are going to change tonight. Something happened. Something happened. God told Abraham. And God said, Abraham, I'm going to visit Sodom. I visited you already. I gave you a miracle. I visited Sarah already. I gave her a miracle. And I know that your nephew Lot is there. I know that the daughters are there. I know the wife is there. I'm going to visit them. God, if you're visiting them, can you please? Because I know about Sodom. Can you please have mercy on them? Tell me the kind of mercy you want me to have for them. Point number two now. Security through righteousness in Sodom. Security. Protection. Preservation. And then the love of God. And the mercy of God. And the miracle of God. Security through righteousness in Sodom. Look at what we're reading now. It's in Genesis chapter 18. And I'm reading from verse 23. And Abraham drew near and said, why will thou destroy the righteous or the wicked? Adventure, there shall be 50 righteous within the city. Will thou also destroy and not spare for the place for the 50 righteous that are therein? That be far from thee to do after this manner, to slay the righteous or the wicked, and that the righteous should be as the wicked, that he that be far from thee shall not the judge of all the earth do right. And the Lord said, if I find in Sodom 50 righteous within the city, then I will spare all the place for their sakes. Security because of the righteous there. Protection because of the righteous there. Preservation because of the righteous there.